Now let's see how we can create the surface of the street on top of the topography. As you can see, the streets are shown by 2D lines, but that's not the problem. It will automatically project those lines on the surface of the topography. It's better if we go to a 2D level, such as the site view. We're going to use the split surface. Click on the topography once, and then you can select the lines that you want to separate the surface. You can select the lines. I want to actually close them here. You can keep going further. The trick here is that the lines need to be a closed loop, right? So you need to make sure that there are not two lines overlapping each other. Also, you need to make sure that it's closed at the two ends of the loop. If there are not lines here to pick up, you can just draw them yourself. If you have already drawn the street lines in AutoCAD, you can just import them and just select them. It would be maybe easier. But it's up to you. We need to close it here. Make sure it's closed on all sides. And here. How about I draw one line in here and close the other side of the street here. So now we have a closed loop. One closed loop. If it's not closed, it's going to tell us. So let's see. We can click on the finish edit mode. Yeah, it was closed, so it's good. As you see, I can take it to the shaded views. Oh, you can see better. As you can see, now we have the same 2D lines projected on the surface of the topography. And you can easily assign a different material to simulate the material of a street. So let's go to the material. Let's see if we have something like a spalt or something. Yep, we do. I'm gonna go with this one. And how about I also change the graphics to be a little bit darker. Okay, and okay here. And that's the surface of the street.